Everyone, in this video we are going to see a problems based on polynomials, which means that algebraic identities. Already we have seen about the 8 basic identities, so based on that we are going to solve some questions. These questions I have taken from Sultan Chand book. Okay, so let's start to solve the questions. The first question, it was taken from exercise 2.8 in Sultan Chand. So whatever we are going to see in this video, this you have to write it in your Sultan Chand notebook. So page number 2.26, the second question, factorize. In that second question we are going to see subdivision A. In that A, third subdivision we are going to solve now. Okay, so the question is 25x squared plus 16y squared plus 4z squared minus 40xy plus 16yz minus 20xz. So this is looking like x plus y plus z the whole square, right? So that we are going to solve now. So the first step will be this. I am going to take it as a square. See, 5x the whole square, 25 is a square of 5, right? So like that I am going to take for every terms. So this 16y squared, it will become a 4y the whole square plus 2z the whole square, and here it is minus, here also it is minus. So which is a term common in both of this? X is a common term, right? So definitely x is going to become a minus, so here also I'm going to place minus. So like this you have to find out that plus and minus. Okay, so this will become plus 2 into minus 5x and 4y plus 2 into 4y and 2z, and then plus 2 into 2z and minus 5x. Okay, so this is like minus 5x plus 4y plus 2z the whole square. Okay, so this will be the answer. Understood? So in this way you have to solve. So now we are going to see the second question, that is B subdivision 2. Okay, so the question is 4x squared plus 9y squared plus 4z squared plus 12xy minus 12yz minus 3zx. The same method as we have done in the previous question, the same method we are going to follow now. So here in this two terms we get minus sign, right? So which is the common term here? Z. So definitely z is going to become a minus. So this can be written as 2x the whole square plus 3y the whole square plus 2z the whole square. So here it will be 2x and 3y, right? That is the formula for x plus y plus z the whole square, right? What is the formula for x plus y plus z the whole square? Is equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. So in that case, in that way we are expanding this. Okay, so the next term will be 2 into, already we have written xy, now we are going to write yz. Okay, so it will become 3y and 2z. As I said, here we get minus term, so definitely z is going to become a minus. So in both z term we have just included the negative sign. Okay, so the next term will be 2 into, so 2 into minus 2z into 2x. Okay, so this can be written as 2x plus 3y minus 2z the whole square. So this will be the answer. Okay, so now we are going to solve the third question. This also the same factorize, but this is looking like different, right? The previous two problems, it is in the base same method, but here it is looking somewhat different. So 1 minus 64a cube minus 12a plus 48a the whole square. So this, here we have a cube term, right? So I am going to take it as a cube. 64 is a cube of 4. So this can be written as 1 cube. Okay, 1 cube minus 4a the whole cube. So definitely this will be become a x minus y the whole cube. So what is the formula for x minus y the whole cube? X minus y the whole cube is equal to x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into x minus y. This will be the formula, right? In this way I'm going to write this. So this can be written as minus 3. What is x and y? It will become 1 and 4a. Am I right? So definitely it will become 12a. So here x minus a, x minus y in the sense 1 minus 4a. Okay, so this can be written as x minus y the whole cube. So 1 minus 4a the whole cube. So this will be the answer. Understood? If you learn the identities properly, you can solve this questions fraction of seconds. Within a fraction of a second, you can finish it off. If you didn't learn, definitely you can't. It will be a very difficult problems for you if you didn't learn the identities. So better try to learn the identities thoroughly. Okay. So the next question is 8p cube plus 12 by 5p squared plus 6 by 25p plus 1 by 125. This also in the same way because cube is there. So definitely this problem only, this identity only. So we are going to solve in same way. So 8p cube can be written as, 8 is a 2 cube, right? 2 cube only 8. So 2p the whole cube plus here. So 8p cube plus, here it is p squared and p. So definitely this will not come here. So this will be the y term. So here it is 1 by 125. 125 is 5 cube. 5 cube value only 125. So this can be written as 1 by 5 the whole cube plus, now what is the formula? 3xy into x plus y, right? So 3 into 2p into 1 by 5. Sorry. Into 1 by 5 and then 3xy you have written, now x plus y, right? So x plus y in the sense 2p plus 1 by 5. Now we will check, 3 2s are 6p, so 6p by 5 will be here. This if you multiply with this, definitely it will become 12 by 5 p squared. Then that 6p by 5 into 1 by 5, this will make 6 by 25p. So definitely this is the correct step, right? So this can be written as 2p plus 1 by 5 the whole cube, right? So the formula we have used here is x plus y the whole cube is equal to x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. See, whenever you are writing without this identity, I will not accept it. Whatever questions you are going to solve, whichever identity you have used, that you have to mention in your answer. Without the identity, it will be considered as a copied one. So don't get confused whenever you are going to solve the questions based on these identities. Which identity you are going to use, that identity you have to write it. Okay, so this will be checked in your assignment as well as exam. Okay, so this will be the answer.